playing professional pool. She was playing league pool.
In a restaurant, you gotta act right.
Yeah, I mean,
today. So I'm going to ask the USA captain and the European captain, Johnny Archer and Albert Ocean, to join me in the arena, please. Well, guys, hard day behind us yesterday. Johnny, I mean, you in the first match for all the teams here, training 5-2, and your guys and girls come back to steal that match 6-5. Must have had some real good feeling in that, huh?
Well, any time you come back with a win like that, it's always a good feeling. But you know, it was just the start, and the start out of the game, the start out of the league, so yes, it felt good.
Lost a little bit of momentum in the next two matches, but 2-1 early days yet, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just now getting started. So, you know, Al and I talked about it. It's just going to be a long week. We hope that it goes down to be a very good match. And, I think our people are ready.
That's cool. Alvin, I mean, when you were 5-2 up, you must have thought, hey, we're home, we're trying. And then they come and hit you. And today, there we go, and today we have 5 matches coming up, 2 in the afternoon session, followed by 3 singles in the evening. What's your plan for today? How many points are you going to get on the board?
I think, like, it's almost the same, like, that it was coming, but we just want to win the session today, and that's probably the most important thing, just to think about the game, win the session, because if we win all the sessions, we win anyway.
Okay, session at a time then. And Johnny, any secrets you want to reveal from your team today? There you go, ladies and gentlemen. That's a bold statement. Thank you very much, guys. If you want to prepare your teams, we'll make this match anyway. Thank you very much. Good luck. And so there you go. You heard it. Johnny Archer, 5-0 for Team America. We shall see. Straight up 2 matches. We have the Scotch doubles in the boys first. We have from Europe, Victor Zielinski and Daniel Maggio up against Nathan Childress and Manuel Perez, followed by the girls, where we have Christina Tkach and Diana Kocheva. They'll be up against April Larson and Sierra Reeves. First of all, we have the boys pairing. Gentlemen, would you please enter the arena and prepare for the match?
Can you see? Your journey begins here.
Okay, gentlemen, you can go and light.
Good afternoon. So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Here is Thomas Wickwins of you from Klagenfurt, Austria, from the Sports Park Arena. We are watching the action from the second day of the battle between your Europe and USA junior teams. And In the first session, we have two matches, two Scotch double matches, and then the players from Europe and USA are ready to start the match. From Europe, the first pair is Viktor Zielinski and Daniel Macho. We both kids are from Poland. And from USA, there is Manny Perez and Nathan Childress. So after first day action, Europe is in the lead, 2-1. However, today I think it's very important day because we have 5 points to win, so whoever takes the advantage of the second day, I think will have the biggest chances to win the total match. And I will tell you a little bit about the first day action for those who were not able to see this. The first match was the team against team. Match where every player from every team has played against each other. And at first, Europe took a huge lead, was leading 5-2. But America has shown the character and steal the point from Europe. First tying the match 5-5 and then winning the hill-hill frame. It looked that this emotional boost gives some advantage for American players, and however, we were not able to capitalize this during the second match. They lost it 6-3. That was a triple match against three players against three players, and in the third match, America was leading 2-0 again, but made some enforced errors, and they lost again 6-3. So, all matches in the tournament is to the 6 points, so not a very long sets, but still long enough to show the advantage. And here we see Manny is trying to put the 7 ball. America, Team America is very close to winning first point in this match. Many players have 9 ball in the pocket. There's a 1-0 for Team America.
Or is Europe 0, USA 1, USA to break. Foul shot.
So I'm back after this small technical break. There were some audio issues here, and we are continuing watching the Atlantic Challenge Cup 2017. And the first match of the afternoon session is between the Daniel Machel and Victor Zelinsky and Nathan Childress and Manny Perez. So we see Daniel in action. A beautiful shot. Daniel. Both Polish guys are very talented players, playing already for many years and have shown tremendous results in Poland. Just a little bit out of position. So Daniel has a quite tough shot. A little bit pocket cheating, but always good for Team Europe. And after the 9-0 pocket, score is 1-1. I will remind you what the match is till the 6 points. Whichever team collects the 6 points will win the match, and overall competition might be up to 4 days. So it looks a little bit like the Moscone Cup format. So whichever team collects the 11 wins will win the Atlantic Challenge Cup. So yesterday we had three matches. Today we have 5 matches, 2 matches in the afternoon session and 3 matches in the evening session. Beautiful break by Daniel Machel. Good control, and it looks like the possible run out for Team Europe. And quite a mistake from Daniel Machel. It wasn't such a hard shot. Unfortunately, lack of focus did not allow him to pot the fifth ball. It's probably because he is a little bit under pressure.
Extension.
That is quite normal for the young guys to play in such important tournament. Manny Perez just tried to bank with 5 ball. Unfortunately, he was not successful. And Victor Zelinsky has an option to go offensive or try to play safe. good shot by Nathan Childress and Team America. Can take a third rack, but just two balls to go. And 2-1, America is in the lead. See, before this match, David Forrest invited both captains to say a few words, and the message from USA team captain Johnny Archie was very clear: 5-0 today for America. So that shows that the American team is very confident about themselves. And yesterday they showed really a game in several occasions. But of course, this is a long tournament, so everything may happen. And Team Europe is very experienced. All the players are the champions.
The score is Europe 1, USA 2, USA 2 break.
Not the best break by Nathan Childress. However, the Team Europe has no other option than to pass the table back to Team USA, I think. If the break was illegal. From where I see, I cannot tell if the break was legal, but it looks like the third ball is in the kitchen, so that means
push out.
Betty has spotted the quite difficult first ball. Unfortunately, no position on the second ball. Is not happy with his safety play, which is of course normal. The opponent may see the second ball or may even try the combo shot. Two nine combination possible. Thank you.
call shot.
Nathan was trying to play the small jump shot. Unfortunately, he executed it in not the best way, but it was a good effort. Now, Team Europe has the open position.
Extension.
Daniel doesn't feel comfortable making the 7 ball, and of course this is very important. Making a mistake here is not the best option. He's trying to make a good position for his putter. Daniel and Victor were able to use the opportunity, left by Team America, and tie the score. Team Europe to break. Next track gives them the opportunity to run away. This is the third year of Atlantic Challenge Cup. The project was started back in 2015.
The score is 2-2. Europe to break.
The first year was also played here in Austria, in Rockwell. Back when Team Europe has won with the score 11-9. It was a very close match. And only in the very end, Europeans were able to win it. The last year, Atlantic Challenge Cup was organized in Chicago, USA. Back then, the European advantage was much bigger. The score was 11-3. And we are looking forward to how this match of both continents will end up. Both teams looks very good, very strong so far. They have the best captains we can imagine. Albin Ushin is the captain for Team Europe, and Johnny Archer is team captain for Team USA. Both are the world champions. Both are the very good pro players, so of course we can give important knowledge to the junior players, and I think this is very important that the youth can learn from somebody. Unexpected miss by Daniel. Usually he doesn't miss those shots, but it seems that Daniel is not playing his same game today. Luckily, the situation is not very easy for Team USA. We don't see
extension,
free ball, and that means they will need to try to resave from here. Manny Perez is playing kick shot, and he was trying to hide the third ball somewhere. Unfortunately, he left the open position. So Viktor Zielinski can choose whichever pocket he wants to pocket free ball. Good play by Viktor Zielinski, and the next point is to Team Europe. Europe is in the lead in the match 4. As we see, some support by the team members, Maxim Dudenets, team captain of the Russian, and Patrick Hoffman, the goal players Diana Kuchayeva and Kristina Tkach are probably practicing. We are next to play against the Sierra Reims and April Larson.
Score is Europe 3, USA 2, USA to break.
Manny Perez executed a break shot for Team USA, and Nathan Childress is aiming for the first ball. And he misses the cut shot to the top left pocket. Nathan is only 40 years old. He is the youngest member of Team USA. Maybe because of his young age, he is a little bit nervous, but so far he's performing very good. Zielinski is not happy about the kick shot he just played, but you can see from his body language. And Manny Perez just pocketed beautiful first ball to the side pocket. The match is played on the Rasson table. This is a match table with very tight pockets, so players must be in really good form. And the cloth is not very fresh, so soon the table will require very precise shooting. Of course, both teams has the practice tables in their own rooms, but the match table is slightly different because the cloth here is a little bit fresh. So from time to time, you can see the players having some difficulties with speech control. Just played the floor ball again, a little bit out of position, and Manny has option to bank the six ball or try to play safety. Both team members can talk to each other.
Extension.
All matches in this tournament are played on a shot clock, so players have 35 seconds for their disposal. Once per rack, each team can have an extension, which your team USA has just used. And we see the beautiful bank shot by many players. Unfortunately, he was not able to control the cue ball. There is no easy continuation here. And the team USA must hurry a bit. We just use the extension. Very important safety shot for team USA. And as we see, the safety play is almost perfect, but I think Daniel can see the seven ball. So this is an opportunity for Team Europe to grab the fourth point and to go into a better lead. Left by Nathan Childress, and now is in the lead 4-2. We see the PPF referee Roman Mikhermedov trying to do his best with racking. And of course, we quick check. By Daniel Machel. Possibility to continue. The two ball goes straight to the side pocket. it looks like a easy run out for the Polish guys. I think Victor wants just a little bit more angle on the but it was beautiful draw shot deformed by him. Match, so Team Europe is on a hill, and quite a strong start by Team USA was not enough for them after several mistakes and several bad safeties. The Team Europe was able to get the lead in this match. Johnny Archer is probably thinking now about what he should say to the Team USA players. Not all is lost.
Scores Europe 5, USA 2, USA to break.
Team USA was in a similar situation yesterday in the first match. That is exactly the same result, 2-5 behind. And as I told before, we were able to steal the first match from Team Europe, winning it 6-5. One more dry break by Nathan Childress, so it's break is not working for Team USA in this match. And of course, breaking in the Iron Bowl is the most important factor. Some error by Daniel Marshall on trying to get position on two ball. And Viktor Zielinski is preparing his jump career. Almost successful jump shot. From this distance it was really a hard shot to do. Of course Victor is a little bit lucky not to leave the open position for Team USA. Good safety shot by Manny Perez. Also from here it seems like the two ball is fully visible. So Daniel Mitchell will probably go offensive. Very good safety shot from Nathan. This time he executed it perfectly.
Extension.
Victor Zielinski showing Massey shot. If four ball is potable, the situation looks easy, but the four and six ball cluster might be a small problem. Just a perfect shot by Team USA. It looks like four ball is not potable, so Team USA will need to figure out how to play a safety from here. A little bit thick. This was played by Manu Perez. With the thinner contact, he could make it really good safety play. Unfortunately, leaving the open situation to Daniel Machin is not the best option. Well played, and there's no doubt this match will continue to do it. And the result is 6-2. After a little bit slow start, Victor Zielinski and Daniel Machin showed the best. And Europe is grabbing another important point, going to the 3-1 lead. I would like to ask the audience not to go away. After the short break, 5 or 10 minutes, we will be back with another